All right, so let us start. So what we are going to do today is we are going to continue what we did, continue from where we left in the last class when we talk about series, right? After that, you have a couple of tutorial classes. So you have one more week to finish. So next week is the last week for the semester. So here is how we are going to do it. Right. So today I will try to finish as much as I can on series, and that will be the end of the syllabus, right? So main lecture notes, main lecture we will end with today class, and then you will have three more classes Monday, Tuesday and Saturday. So on Monday, Tuesday and Saturday we will do tutorials and we will do some problems from the previous exam papers as well, end of course exam papers. I believe one of the old exam paper, the past paper is uploaded in the LMS, so you should be able to see that now, right? If not, you can contact the tutorial assistant or the assistant lecturer to get a copy of that, or ask him to upload it again in the LMS if you didn't get it. So he will go over some of the tutorial problems and some of the problems on the past paper, just to give you a indication on how you are expected to write the answers in the end of course exam, right? So as of now, the faculty has we have no information about when you will have the end of course exam or how we are going to have the in-course assessment exam, right? So as of now, they are planning to start the second semester without going for the exam on the second week of December, right? So end of this month, you will have end of semester, and then you will have a 1 week holiday. And after that, they are going to start the next semester, right? Without giving you an exam. And when the situation gets normal, and whenever you are allowed to come into the university, they will decide about having an exam, but maybe before that they will have 1 week of revision class or something, that is not decided yet. So as of now, we will try to finish the syllabus by this week, and then we will do the tutorial next week and past paper next week. And after that, we will let you know whenever the faculty decided how to conduct the exam and when to conduct the exam. Otherwise, you will be going into the next semester courses from second week of December. The faculty or dean office will inform you about the timetable and everything on another time, right? So that is how that is the situation now here, right? So I can tell you about the situation now. What we are going to do is we are going to continue on series, right? So series, what we are talking about in the last class is we talk about some kind of a test, right? So we try to see what do we mean by series, and then we see that we can create sequences from the series by generating the partial sums, and then we see that all the properties or all the convergence criteria we have applied for sequences work for series as well, right? So by the mean of using the partial sum as the sequence. And then we see that what are the alternative ways of verifying the convergence or divergence of the series, right? In order to do that, we do some tests, right? So we develop some results which are known as test for convergence, which guarantees the convergence of the test, right? So far we talk about something called p test, right? Summation of 1 upon n to the power p converges, and then we see the comparison test, and then we see limit comparison test, and we see ratio test and all those things, right? So there are several tests I told you earlier. Now I'm going to continue with the other test, right? So this is test 4, if I remember correctly. Last time I did test 3. Right, for all the tests, the proofs are given in your lecture notes, right? They are not that hard to read and understand, but we mainly focus on how to solve problems by using the test, right? So that is what we are going to focus on. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just give you the test and then give you an example of how to apply the test. So this test 4 is called root test. Right, so root test. So in root test, what we do is this. Right, so this is what the root test says. Right, if the nth component in the sequence to the power 1 upon n is strictly less than 1, then we can say that the sequence converges. Right, by root test we can say that the sequence summation converges. Right, so let's see an example. Example, let us say we consider a series right, so we consider this series. Now we have to see whether this is convergent or not, right? The question is it convergent? Right, if it is convergent, then you have to justify your answer, right? So that is how we are going to do this. So let's take the nth term. Right, so you know un is this, n over n plus 1 to the power n square. Right, so that is the nth term here. So clearly you can compute, and this is obviously greater or equal to 0 for all n. That is not a big thing because n is greater or equal to 0, so this one is always greater or equal to 0. Right, so now what we have to do is we have to check for un to the power 1 upon n. Right, so un to the power 1 upon n, so this is going to be n over n plus 1 to the power n squared over n, right? Because n squared to the power 1 upon n is n squared over n, so that is n. And so you can simplify this. Right, so if you simplify this, you can write it as 1 over 1 plus 1 upon n, the whole quantity to the power n. But 1 to the power n is 1, so you can put the numerator as 1, and then denominator 1 plus 1 upon n to the power n. So obviously, the denominator, right, is less or equal to 2. Right, so eventually this one is less or equal to half. So it's strictly less than. So you can say this is less than half. So that is clearly 1, less than 1, right? So this is less than 1, half. So this is less than 1. At the same time, because of this, you know this is also 0, and this is for all n. So for every n, now you know that un to the power 1 upon n is less, strictly less than 1. So by root test, you can see that this one is convergent. Right, so by the root test, the series is convergent. Okay, so now this is the root test. So next what we are going to do is to, we are going to see a developed version of this root test. Right, so some cases the root test may not be enough to justify the convergence, right? Because sometimes when you put u n to the power 1 upon n, it may not be easy for you to show that that is strictly less than 1, right? So here in this example, because this example is simple, it becomes easier for you to show that u n to the power 1 upon n is less than 1, right? But it is not necessarily easier in all the cases. So in some other cases where you may not be able to use the root test, what you can do is you can use the test number 5. It is called Cauchy root test. Right, test number 5 is Cauchy root test. Right, so here what we do is we take the limit of this. Right, so let's take the limit of the absolute value of un to the power 1 upon n, right? So and say that that is L, right? So this one is, say it is L. So then what you have is this. Right, so if L is greater than 1, then we say that the sequence, absolute value of the sequence, right, summation of absolute value of un diverges, right? So if limit A is less than 1, then we say that the sequence is absolutely, sorry, series is absolutely converges, right? So that means the absolute value of the components summation is convergent, right? So that is what we mean here. So let's again do the example, right? Okay, so let's see another series. We can do that one again, but we will go for another series. So let us see this series, right? Summation of n to the power 4 over 2 to the power n, right? So let's consider this series. So you can write what is un, right? N to the power 4 over 2n. Right, so now you need to take the limit. Okay, so you take limit of absolute value of un to the power 1 upon n. Here all are positive. N is positive, so n to the power 4 is positive. 2 is positive, 2 to the power n is positive. So even if you take the absolute value, you still get n to the power 4 over 2 to the power n. And then you take 1 upon n power of that. So you will end up with n to the power 4 over n divided by 2. 2 to the power n over n, that is 2 to the power 1. Now when n goes to infinity, you know this goes to 0. So when the power goes to 0, that numerator part goes to 1. So it's going to 1 upon 2. So this turned out to be 1 half, which is less than 1, right? So in that case, you see that absolute convergence, right? So you can say that the sequence series is absolutely convergent, right? Okay, so n to the power 4 over 2 to the power n . This is what you can say, right? So you cannot say immediately, you cannot say convergent, right? Because of Cauchy root test, what you can say is this is absolutely convergent. Limit is strictly less than 1, so absolutely convergent. But one of the theorem we studied in the last class, right, when we talk about absolute convergence, it says this. But you know, right, you know this theorem, right? We studied in this chapter, in this section, that absolute convergence implies convergence. Right? If the series is absolutely convergent, then the series is convergent. Right? But converse is not necessarily true. So now, because it is absolutely convergent, the series is convergent. Right? So hence, so this is convergent. So this is the example of a Cauchy root test. Right? You can do the same thing for the other example as well. Okay, so this is test number 5. Now what we are going to do is we are going to talk about test number 6. Right? That is called ratio test attributed to D'Alembert. So we will name that as D'Alembert's ratio test. Okay, so this is called D'Alembert's ratio test. Right, so this says the following. Okay, so so this time what we do is we take the limit of the ratio of two successive terms. Right? Whenever all the terms, right, so for all n, this one should be for all n. That is understandable because if it is 0, then you cannot divide by 0. Right? So for all n, the terms are non-zero. Right? So in that case, what you do is you take the limit of the ratio between two successive points. So when you take the ratio between two successive points, absolute value of the ratio, and then take the limit. If the limit is less than one, then we say that it is absolutely convergent, right? The series is absolutely convergent, but you already know an absolute convergent implies convergence. So eventually you can say the series is convergent as well. If the limit is strictly greater than one, then you can say the absolute value of the summation diverges. So again, we are going to skip the proof of all these things, and we are only going to look at the examples. So summation of n over 2 to the power n, right? So you know that this is your UN, right? So the UN is n over 2 to the power n, and that is clearly non-zero. It is obvious for you, right? So now what you need to do, you take the ratio between two successive points, use two successive terms, and then take the limit. So let me do that. So that is limit of n goes to infinity, absolute value of un plus 1 is n plus 1 over 2 to the power n plus 1 divided by n over 2 to the power n, right? So your un plus 1 is n plus 1 over 2 to the power n plus 1, and un is n over 2 to the power n. So you can simplify this. So if you simplify this, you will get this limit of n goes to infinity, right? All are positive numbers, so there is no need for absolute value anymore, right? So absolute value of a positive number is the number itself. So you can drop the absolute value 2 to the power n and 2 to the power n plus 1. So there is a 1 upon 2, right? And then you will have n plus 1 over n. Okay. So you have limit of n goes to infinity 1 upon 2 times n plus 1 over 2n, right? So this 2 to the power n plus 1 comes down and 2 to the power n goes up. So when we cancel out, you get 1 half and then this. So this is basically this, right? So 1 half, you can take it out. Limit n goes to infinity 1 plus 1 upon n. And so this limit is half. You all know that. Right? So that is less than 1. So okay, so hence this is convergent. Okay, so we will see one more example. Okay, second example, summation of n factorial divided by 3 into 5 into all the way up to 2n plus 1. Right? So n factorial divided by odd numbers, multiplication of odd numbers. One, you don't need to put one times, 3 times, 5 times, 7 times, 9 times. So all the way up to 2n plus 1 times. Right? So this is what you have as a sequence. So you have to take limit. So again, because all of them are natural numbers, all are positive, so I don't need to have the absolute value anymore. And so all I need to do is do this. Right, so I have n plus 1 factorial divided by 3 plus 3 times, 5 times, all the way up to 3. The whole quantity divided by n factorial into 3 into 5 into all the way up to n plus 1. Right, because when you have n factorial here, you have 2n plus 1. So when you have n plus 1, this is 2 times n plus 1 plus 1. So that is 2n plus 3. Right? So that is understandable. And when you simplify this, you get limit of n goes to infinity. Right? This by n factorial. That is n plus 1, right? N plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial is n plus 1, right? So you know that. 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial is 3. 4 factorial divided by 3 factorial is 4, right? So that's that's clear for you. And here you have 3, 5, 3 cancel, 5 cancel, all the way cancel. And this is the term 2n plus 1. Here the last term is 2n plus 3. So the previous term should be 2n plus 1, right? So clearly all of them cancelled out and you ended up with 2n plus 3. So you, when you simplify un plus 1 over un, you ended up with n plus 1 over 2n plus 3. So limit of this function, n goes to infinity, you know the answer, right? A level math. N goes to infinity, 1 plus 1 upon n over 2 plus 3 upon n, right? So you can factor out an n from the numerator and the denominator and cancel each other. So you will end up with n, 1 plus 1 upon n divided by 2 plus 3 upon n. Right? So then you have, this is half. And which is less than 1. So again, you know that by this D'Alembert test, ratio test, the series is absolutely convergent and hence it is convergent. So this is about D'Alembert ratio test. And again, in the lecture notes, we gave you sufficient examples so you can look at it again and try to see how those examples are done, right? So we gave the answers as well, so you can easily see. Now we will move into the one final section, right? So this is a special type of series, right? So that is called alternating series. So you know this, we have seen this example several times. Minus 1 to the power n. And so this is a very famous example we have been using in this course for many places, at many places, mostly whenever we are trying to give a counter example, right? Minus 1 to the power n is one of the famous examples we use, right? So that is called alternating series. So alternating series. So alternating means it will go to one point, come back again to another point, go back to the previous point, and come back again, right? So it will oscillate here and there. So these are some examples, right? -1 +1 -1 +1 -1 +1. So minus term and plus term is alternatively repeating, right? First is a minus term, second is a plus term, or first is a plus term, second is a minus term, whatever the order is, right? So a positive term followed by a negative term, and that is again followed by a positive term, right? So that is how we do that. Or so first example is the positive and minus terms are same in -1 +1 -1 +1, or you can say -1 +2 -3 +4 -5 +6 and so on, right? So that is also an alternating series, and because you have a -++ -++, so +++ -++ like that, and so that is an example of alternating series. So in general, right, so this is how we denote it. Right, with the term A and B being positive, right, we write an alternating series as -1 to the power n times an. Right, so if you put an is equal to 1, then my first example, -1 +1 -1 +1. Right, so if you put an is equal to n, then you will have the second example, -1 +2 -3 +4, so on, right? So that is, so you can choose n as any one, right? So then that is how we do this, right? So that is the alternating series. So now let us talk about the convergence of this alternating series. So there is a test for that. Right, so litmus test is the test will be applied to see the or verify the convergence of the alternating series, right? So these are the necessary conditions for that. Okay, so this is the test for the convergence. If the sequence an, right, is a part in the alternating series, is a decreasing, positive decreasing sequence, right? At the same time, if it is a positive decreasing sequence and if the sequence converges to zero as n goes to infinity, right, then we call that the series is convergent, right? Okay, so we can see an example. Right, so if you consider the series like this, right? Summation of 1 upon n times, minus 1 to the power n times 1 upon n, right? So here, you know that right, so you can see that 1 upon n, that is your an here, right? In place of an, you have 1 upon n. So 1 upon n is positive, and as long as n is positive, 1 upon n is positive, and it is a decreasing sequence, right? 1, 1 over 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, 1 upon 5. So it is decreasing, and clearly, you know 1 upon n goes to 0 as n goes to infinity, which we studied very long time ago, right? So those are the two conditions you need here, right? The series, a sequence should be positive and decreasing. At the same time, it should converge to 0. Then the series converges. So this one converges. Okay, so this is an example for convergent of a alternating series, right? So the convergent of alternating series depend on what kind of a sequence you are having with inside the alternating series, right? It depends on what you have as an, right? So here, if I put an as n, then you know it is not converged, right? Because it is an increasing sequence, so it cannot be converged. So this part should be important in the convergence. So another results regarding the alternating series is conditional convergence. Right, so this is called conditionally convergent. So you know that, right? So okay, so if the series un is convergent, but the absolute value series, summation of absolute value un diverges, right? then in that case we say that the series is conditionally convergent, right? This kind of case exists in alternating series, right? In other cases, most of the time, if you have positive terms, then absolute value of the positive term and absolute value of the positive term and the term itself are same, right? So in those cases, mostly un and summation of un are same. But in the case of alternating series, you can see that summation of absolute value of un is different from summation of un, right? So even in a simple example, you can see that. So clearly, that is a case when you have conditional convergence, right? So let me give you an example. Okay, so let us say this is conditionally convergent. We want to prove this. Actually, we want to prove that this is conditionally convergent. Right, so okay. Right. So conditionally convergent. So you have to show that un converges and absolute value of un diverges. So first we will try to show un is convergent. Right. So clearly you know that this. Right. So you know that an is 1 upon n. And minus 1 to the power n plus 1 over n. So clearly, an is 1 upon n, right? So that is, you know, there I show you, right? It is positive. Positive, decreasing, and this goes to 0 as n goes to infinity, right? So these are clear. Because minus 1 to the power n plus 1 over 1 upon n, right? So you can say an as n, 1 upon n. Or actually, if you want to do it as in the theory, you know, it has to be n minus 1, but it doesn't matter, right? So this is positive decreasing, right? So again, say 1 upon n, because there's no difference of considering a series sequence 1 upon n and 1 upon n minus 1. Both are same. So you know 1 upon n is positive, decreasing, and goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. So by Leibniz test, this one is convergent. So now you have to say the other one is divergent, right? Because you want to prove that it is conditionally convergent. So you want to prove the other one is divergent. So you have to take absolute value of the series, right? Right, so next you take absolute value of un, right? So you prove convergent of summation of un. Now you have to show that summation of absolute value of un is divergent, right? So you take absolute value of summation of minus 1 to the power n over n. So clearly that is 1 upon n. Right? So we will show it by contradiction, right? So let us assume it is convergent, right? So then If it is convergent, then by Cauchy criteria, you can say that it satisfies the Cauchy condition, right? We studied or we proved this earlier, right? So you can apply the Cauchy case, right? So in this case, what you do is, right? So in this case, what you do is use n as capital, small n as capital N, and small m as 2n, right? And epsilon as 1/4. Right? So in this case, you will get this. And right? So 1/n plus 1/n plus 1, that's all the way up to 1/2n is less than 1/4. Right? So this is what you will have when you choose m, n, and epsilon as 2n, n, and 1/4 respectively. So if you simplify this, right, so this gives you, when you sum all these things, right, so this means 1/2n plus 1/2n plus all the way up to 1/2n is less than 1/4, right? Because 1/2n is smaller than 1/n, 1/2n is smaller than 1/n plus 1. We did similar kind of technique in other cases also, right? So it's the same technique. So eventually you will get 2n, summation of n times 1/2n is less than 1/4. And so this turned out to be half is less than 1/4, which is a contradiction, right? So your assumption is wrong. So the series is, summation of this is not convergent, right? So then it is divergent. So this one diverges, right? So here you prove series is convergent, and here you prove absolute value of the series is divergent. So that is what we call as conditional convergence, right? So this is an example of how you prove the conditional convergence. So conditional convergence mostly come for the alternating series, right? So other series, most of the cases you cannot have conditional convergence, but there are some special cases where you may have conditional convergence. But most of the time, the conditional convergence comes under alternating series. So this is what we need to learn on series. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to stop with this, right? So this concludes the lecture part, right? Main theoretical lecture part is completed with this lecture. So what you have learned from day one up to today will be covered for the exam. So you cannot skip anything, right? So everything which I teach in the class, right? So which I taught in the class will be covered for the exams, right? End of course exam. But in course, if we have to conduct something, then I will let you know how to conduct the in course and everything. But other than that, it is fine. Right. So as of now, this is the end of the main lectures. Next Monday you will have tutorial, and then Tuesday again you will continue tutorial, and Saturday you will have some past paper discussions as well. Right. So next week it is all tutorial and past paper, and after that we will end the semester. Right. And next semester, I don't know, the dean office will inform you about the timetable and everything. Right. So this is the material which we can cover for this 1 or 2 course, right? So I will stop here, and then Monday class you will have tutorial discussions.